Welcome to the Daily Prophetic Word. The Daily Prophetic Word for Wednesday, the 20th of November 2019 is consider. Consider what I have told you through my prophets and apostles. Consider that from this day forward I will bless you. I will bless you if you follow my commandments and abide in my ways. Come close to me and copy my examples that I have set for you. Consider. Consider what is written in the Holy Scriptures and what I have taught you through my complete ministry on earth. I am coming for my bride now, but I am looking for a bride who has made herself ready and who has enough oil in her lamp. Consider. Consider your ways and compare them to my paths. Are they the same? Has the spirit of Elijah who runs before me convicted you to repentance? And have you repented so that you become holy as I am holy? I will clothe my bride in the finest linen available, and I will take her to my father's house. Are you worthy to be my bride, tried and ready to get married? And this was the Daily Prophetic Word given for Wednesday, the 20th of November 2019. Consider. My dear brothers and sisters, consider the ways of the Lord, not only part of his ministry like the cross or the resurrection, but consider what he has done, what he has shown us, and what he has told us through the parables. What has he said? How should we act? Should we act to fight one another, or should we act in brotherly love? Should we love our neighbor or condemn our neighbor? Follow his ways and become closer to him, because as a bride comes very close to the bridegroom, so also we have to come close to the bridegroom. We have to come close to Jesus. How do we do that? By abiding in his whole ministry, in his teaching, in his words, in his examples that he has shown us. Not only picking one scene from the ministry and then claiming whatever you are claiming, and the rest you leave out. Jesus never said that once you believe, you can sit on your sofa and wait for him to come to collect you. He has always said, leave the world behind, leave everything worldly, all the temptations behind, give your money to the poor, and then take your cross and follow me. Why has he said that? Not because you should be poor, but he has said that because you should get rid of all the things that can divert you from the true path. If you are in the world, you will walk the wide path and not the narrow path. Only if you are fully concentrated in faith, by grace, and through actions, righteous deeds of the saints, then you are truly committed and abide in the Lord. Do not be afraid to do righteous deeds of the saints, to lift up the needy. This is not what is meant in the letters that Paul and Peter said about the law. You know very well that the people who followed the law never believed in Jesus Christ. They only had works. They had no faith, they had nothing, they received nothing by grateful faith. They never believed in Jesus Christ. They only had works, and that cannot save you. But on the other hand, only faith alone is not complete. You have to bring both together. Just listen to your heart. As soon as you are saved by grace, through faith, then your heart will yearn that you go forward and help people, because you will have a compassionate heart, a heart filled with the love of the Father. It is impossible for a true Christian to sit at home and see people suffering and are not willing to help. That's not possible. That's only possible if you have one leg in the world, where you still have your ego, where you still have your self-righteousness, where you still follow the temptation of Satan. But it's not possible if both legs are standing in the heavenly realm, because then your heart, filled with compassion, will guide you. The Holy Spirit will guide you to do righteous deeds every day. And you will never ever call anybody out. You will never use slander onto anybody if you are a true Christian. Completely sold out to the Lord, completely abiding in the Lord. You can never say that this person is a hypocrite, this one is a blasphemer, or this one is a stumbling block. You cannot do that. It is impossible. Because you are a changed person. You are newly born. You have nothing to do anymore with this world, but everything to do with the heavenly kingdom. That's also the reason why it's called the gospel of the kingdom. It's all about the kingdom of God. It's all about his coming kingdom onto earth. It's nothing about this world. It's not about gaining riches in this world or having a good life or following your careers or whatever. Jesus has called all the apostles away from their jobs. They were fishers, they were whatever, and they all came out. And after Jesus' ascension, when they received the Holy Spirit, they never went back to be fishers. Not fishers of fish, fishers of men. Because they were completely sold out and they were completely newly born. And they had nothing to do anymore with the world, but everything to do with the heavenly kingdom. Thank you that you have listened to this daily prophetic word. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. If you need additional teachings and want to hear more words, then please listen to the video in our Great Exodus series. That will explain more what will happen, what will be the next step, and how you can be abiding fully in the heavenly kingdom. I hope I will see you again tomorrow. Have a blessed day. Maranatha.